Hi guys, this is Gregor from PreSonus, and today I want to tell you everything about track and part automation in Studio One. Now, the first thing that you need to know about the distinction between part and track automation is that part automation is only available on instrument tracks in Studio One. Both have their inherent advantages, both are great in several situations, but before we look at that, let's first of all establish perhaps a rule of thumb when you should start applying automation to stuff, okay? So whenever you're tweaking a parameter, let's say the cutoff on this bass, to give it a bit more movement and animation, and you wish that this would just repeat over without you having to hold down your mouse button at all times, that's where you should pause for a second and say, hey, I should add an automation for this parameter. So in case you're new to audio production and you're wondering, hey, when is actually the correct time to automate something? Well, then this is maybe a good rule of thumb to follow. To add an automation, what you can do on any parameter, no matter if it's an audio track or it's a virtual instrument on an instrument track, you can always right-click a parameter and then edit automation. As soon as you do that, you see this line appear, and then you can work either with left click, you know, just adding a couple of points. And notice that since version 5.2, the button is turning green as soon as automation is active and red. Or you can also use the very handy paint tool, which just follows very precisely every move. So you can draw ramps up or down. You can do sine waves and stuff like that. Maybe you have a more steady hand than me, then this is even more easy. Or if you don't, then you can actually use these very handy presets that we have. So we have a couple of preset waveforms, for example, sine waves. Those are great if you want to do panning automation. You can also offset these by holding down Command on the Mac or Control on the Windows PC, or hold down Option to change the frequency. We also have parabolas, which are great for ramps that are very, very perfect, you know, like that. So this is stuff that you can toy around with. Another way you can add a track automation in Studio One, and this is particularly handy for power users who want to add multiple automations at once, is to just tick the parameter that you want and then press Option and A on a Mac or Alt and A on a Windows PC and check it out. I was just adding like six different automation lanes here. If you want to work like this though, please note that you have to have recently touched as the selected preference here in the control link box. This is very important because otherwise the parameters that you're touching are not immediately added, so the keyboard shortcut that follows wouldn't work. Now what you can also do, and this is something that is very, very unique to Studio One, is go to the control link box up here. And if you click and drag from the hand tool, you can either drag directly onto the track, or what you can also do is move the automation directly onto an entirely new track. So you're able in Studio One to decouple your automation track from your instrument and audio track, which would potentially allow you to put all of your automations or some of your automations in their own folder and edit and treat that completely separately from the rest of your composition. This is something that some people prefer because it keeps things very decluttered and very nicely organized. But even if you don't want to work like that, just know that it's available for maximum flexibility, because Studio One follows your workflow and adjusts to your workflow, not the other way around. And this is already the part in the video, no pun intended, where we have to talk about part automation, because from this hand icon here, not only can you drag directly onto the automated track or on a dedicated new track, but you can also drag it directly onto the part, just like that or like this. All right, and as soon as you do that, you're gonna add another automation lane down here. Okay, and you can show and hide them with this little button here. So by default, we see velocity, node controller, sound variations, modulation, pitch bend, and aftertouch data. And after that drag and drop from that control link box here, you also see the parameter that you just added. As another example, let's look at delay. Let's say I want to animate my delay. To get a little bit more movement into this, that can once again drag directly from here, or also from here if you click on the gear wheel to my part. And as soon as I do that, you'll see there's another automation part lane added. Can also do this manually if I want to have a full overview of all the available parameters by clicking on the three dots here. This is going to open up the part automation assignment menu. And from there, it works pretty much the exact same way that we just looked at with track automation. You can once again start drawing. You can also hold down command to directly access the paint tool. What you can also do is select several preset waveforms, the exact same ones that you've looked at previously. And you can also see that this automation is visually reflected in the part now. So this means that as I'm moving this part around, I'm also moving the automation with it at all times. Also, when I split the part, the automation is split as well, which can be very handy for editing. Now, this is of course also possible with track automation. So let's say that I have a little automation going on here, right, like that. And I want to move this along with an event that I might have. And this is absolutely possible, but you need to have the option automation follows events enabled for that. Another advantage though that you have with this part automation is that if you render this out as a music loop, which you can do by simply opening up the browser, going to the files tab, then navigating to any folder that you want and then dragging this out, this is gonna render what you just had into a music loop that you can also pre-audition if you want. And as soon as you drag that back into your project, you see that it has the exact same automation. So when you wanna work with music loops, you have to write part automation if you wanna have that rendered and recalled. Another advantage that you have only with part automations is when you're working with a so-called shared copy. The default keyboard shortcut for that is Shift and D. And this has the advantage that as soon as I edit automation, part automation on one of these parts now, these changes are reflected on the other one as well. So for example, if I want to use the transform tool, which is also available here from the paint tool, then I can start compressing down values, you know, and the changes of that would be immediately reflected on my other part as well. We have a lot more videos here on our YouTube channel covering automation in depth. So feel free to check these out if you want to learn more about automation. I hope this was helpful to you and see you next time.